Hi, you guys. Welcome back, or welcome if you are new. I am Colorful Camille, or KK, if we cool, all right? And I just wanted to kind of share with you guys the latest additions to my beauty collection or my beauty stash, things I've purchased over the last month or two, I believe. There's a few items that I'm still waiting to come in, but I'm tired of waiting to do this video. I want to dive into this stuff, take a look. I'll probably do some swatches. I won't swatch everything because it can get out of hand, but I will swatch some things that I'm curious about, and you know, you guys can chime in the comment section. Let me know if you have any of these items, if you like them, if you don't, if you think I will like them. But this is my haul box that I want to go through with you guys. It's like I go through phases. I can go like 6 months, a year or whatever without really feeling the need to buy any makeup or beauty products. And then I can get into this real frenzy of just basically buying everything that I'm interested in and love. So the last couple of months I've been in a buying phase, really. So let's just jump right in and talk about some of the new items that I picked up. Now, this item I actually purchased before, a couple of months ago. This is the Morphe Euphoric Rush, one of their blushes that, you know, look like that, kind of looks kind of freaky. But the one that I purchased, the shade that I purchased, I don't know if you guys remember, in my Shop My Stash, I had tried it. It was way too dark, did not like it. It made me look like I had bruised my face. And so I was kind of iffy on whether or not I was going to try a new shade. But I decided to go ahead and try this one, which is Hypnotized. And I'm kind of excited to try it. I'm not going to swatch it because it feels kind of weird. And it's pretty much like the color of the blush is what it looks like. So there's really no need to swatch it, I don't think. It does feel a little weird to me going on, but they are really pretty. It's like it has that combination of the blush with whatever the skincare stuff is that's in there. It's just kind of unique and different and just kind of, I don't know, kind of freaky. So I did want to go ahead and try another color and see if it's that I just don't like the blush, or if I don't like, or didn't like the color, or if it's that I don't like the blush at all. So I did buy another one of those to try. Now I also grabbed one of these Morphe Hot Shot blush drops. And this one is in the shade Fireball. So this is what it looks like in the package. And it's kind of like in this squeezy tube type thing that looks like this. So, I don't know. I'm hoping that it's not super hard to get out. The squeezy tube, it does feel a little bit squeezy. So, that's what it looks like. It looks like it's pretty pigmented. You know, you can definitely see the shade there. Really gorgeous, really bright. So, yeah. I'm excited to try that. I'm curious if it's going to blend out nicely or not. I haven't really watched any reviews on this. So, not sure, but excited to try it. I think it's a really pretty bright shade since we're still in summer, you know, let's go ahead and do it. Okay, so now I did kind of get into a lip product frenzy for some reason. I am really in a lip gloss, just kind of like nude lip gloss, or I don't know. I'm just really in a lip gloss, lip balm type era, lip oil type era right now. And so I wanted to restock up on my Fenty gloss balms. And so I grabbed these five from Sephora. I believe they're all different shades that I got. So I got the Champ Stamp, which I've never tried, Champ Stamp Fantasy, and Sweet Mouth. I don't think I've tried either one of those, to be honest with you. So I got those two shades. And then I also got the Fenty Glow, of course, which I've tried. And I got the Fuchsia Flex. It looks like I got two Fenty Glows because I like to keep one in my purse. So why the the label is different. I don't know, but as you can see, the label is smaller on one of them. But I got two Fenty Glows, and then I got the Fuchsia Flex, which really excited to try because I've never used this one before. I didn't purchase it, but it's just really, really pretty. So you can see that is gorgeous. The Fuchsia Flex. Ah, she's pretty. Let me just go ahead and show you the Sweet Mouth. That's an interesting name. I don't think I've had the Sweet Mouth either, but I may have because it looks like one. It looks like a shade that I would have had. Just a real kind of shiny, glossy, natural shade. This one is the Champ Stamp. And it looks like this one might be a little more... Yeah, this has a little bit more color in there than the Sweet Mouth and then the Fenty Glow. I'm sure everybody knows what the Fenty Glow looks like. Oh, I know why the Fenty Glow, one of them is different than the other. It's because this one is the stick. I bought one of the stick and I actually was using it. Used it quite a bit. I really like it. So this is the regular Fenty Glow shade for the lip balm gloss. I really, really do like this stick, but I don't like it better than the regular gloss applicators. As you can see here, I've definitely been using it. I've used it quite a bit actually. And it feels nice, it looks nice, but it's just not as shiny to me. And it feels a little different on the lips than the regular Fenty Glow lipsticks or lip glosses. So it's very nice, but I don't like it better than the regular gloss applicator. So yeah, got those. Now this Essence Lip Oil, I had already purchased one of these from Ulta a couple of months back, but I really like it. I really do. I mean, for what, $4, $4.99? It's a really, really nice lip oil. I like it, so I grabbed another one of those. Now these two, I saw someone using these on YouTube. I don't remember who I was watching, but these are from She Glam. I think I might only have one other thing from She Glam, maybe a concealer that my friend gave me, but these are two, what are they called? Pout Perfect Shine Lip Plumpers. So I got these two, and these are the two shades that I got, Pink Flamingo and it looks like In Bloom. So those are the two colors that I got. And these are really, really slim. I'm just looking, you know, when I got the boxes, I purchased these off of Amazon. I wanted that instant gratification, just boom, you know, get it next day. I didn't feel like ordering them from, what is it, Shein, I think, that has these. I didn't feel like ordering them from Shein and waiting a week for them to come. So this is what it looks like. It has a little clicker thing on the bottom to push it up. But this is what the lip gloss looks like. And so I'm excited to try these out. I don't want to, you know, contaminate it by wiping it on my hand or swatching it on my hand and stuff, because who knows when I'll get to these. I have so many other lip products to use. But I was just really, really curious as far as if I like them or not. When I got them on Amazon, I think I paid like $7 each for these, but you can get these on Shein, I think, for like $5, $4.99 or something. So I did pay extra for the instant gratification on those. And I think these are the last of the lip products that I bought. I saw these on Instagram. It was like a reel. And I got these initially. They caught my attention because the packaging is so pretty. These are from Hard Candy and they are called Lip Slide Creamy Lip Oils. So they're lip oils, but they're creamy. And so I got four different shades. Let me show you the shades that I got so you can check them out. And they're the same color as, you know, the packaging or whatever, so you can figure out which is which. But these are the four shades that I got. Hopefully you can read those. Really, really gorgeous. I think these are all the shades that they had. If I'm not mistaken, I believe I picked all four, but who knows. Okay, so I just took them all out of their packaging just so you can see what the actual lip gloss looks like. Container, so cute. Look how cute these are. These are adorable. I love how they look. The colors are so pretty. So let me just take a look. I don't know if I'm gonna swatch all of these, but okay. So that's what that one looks like. Really pretty. Gorgeous. And then this one looks a little bit more, oh, they look super shiny. Super shiny and gorgeous. You know what? Let me put. They're really light. Really light. Oh, that's pretty. I like. I like you like. Okay. So let me swatch this pink one right quick. Pretty. That's what the pink one looks like. Gorgeous. And like I said, these are lips like creamy lip oils. So they're not glosses. You know, I'll put the red one in front. Okay, so that's the red one there. So they're not glosses, they're lip oils. And that's, I'm sure, why they feel so super light on my lips, but they are super shiny. And I absolutely love that. Oh, it's so pretty. And I believe those, I got those from Walmart. I ordered them from the Walmart website, and I actually got these like next day, which is crazy to me. And I believe they were like $7 each, so not too much. Not as inexpensive as the Essence, but I mean, with the packaging and the color and how nice they feel, you know, I feel like it's worth $7. Blush. I got this blush from Sephora. This one is it Tiger Lily? It's one of their two-tone ones. And this is one that I didn't have, and I just thought, oh, that's pretty. I really, really would like to try this out for the summer. It looks gorgeous. So, yeah, I'm going to try that one out. Okay, so let's move into some palettes. I did actually grab some drugstore palettes. And some of these palettes I actually wanted to try years ago and just never did because the price, I didn't feel like I wanted to spend that on any drugstore palettes. But Collab Beauty, the ones that are at Sally Beauty, they were having a sale on their website, I think in store as well. And so I grabbed the smaller eyeshadow palettes because I've always wanted to try these and never have because I didn't want to pay like $20 per palette. And so I don't know how much I paid for these. $7? $6? I don't know, but they were on a good sale. So this first one here is sweet. Nope. Mm-mm. Not about to do that. This first one here is Sunset Dreams. Y'all ain't gonna have me out here looking crazy. Talking about KK, that's not. Dang, and it doesn't. I'm just gonna show it to you like this because they have this little plastic seal on here and I don't feel like cutting all of those. So this one is Sunset Dreams. Has little pops of color in there. Looks like this shimmer here has a little bit of duochrome-ness to it. This one here is called Follow Me, and this one is really pretty. This is one of the ones that I wanted the most, of course, because I love blue eyeshadow. And so this is one that I really, really wanted to grab. You can kind of get a better idea on the back of the shades in there. So yeah, that one is really pretty. And let me show you the back of this one too, just in case you didn't get to see it that well. This was the first one. The Sunset Dreams, really pretty. This one here is First Impressions. So this one is kind of like the purple toned one, and it's cool tone purples, not warm tones. So that's what those shades look like. really pretty. And it's, you know, on the back it gives you kind of instructions on how to create an eye look, just in case you're not that well versed in eyeshadow. So here's this one, which is best of the day. Nice warm red neutrals. And then the last one that I grabbed is After Hours, which really has a strong green tone to it. Very, very pretty. So that's what the shades look like in there. Yeah, really pretty. So I grabbed those while they were on sale, and I'm actually excited to try them out. Like I said, I've been wanting to try out eyeshadows from Collab for a long time, but I didn't because I didn't want to pay $20 for each palette. Okay, so next for drugstore shadows, I got this Revolution Ultimate Desire Jewel Fixation. Now, I was in Target. This was a little while back ago, and I was perusing through, you know, the items they have in the beauty section, and I was looking at this and I was like, I'm really curious as far as like the shimmers in these palettes, just like, are they as nice as they look? I don't know, you know, it's drugstore or whatever, and I don't remember how much I paid for this palette, but yeah, they're not looking too bad. They are not looking too bad, actually, for them to be from Revolution, you know. So let's just take a little gander. Is that a duochrome, a multichrome, or am I tripping? Yeah, I might be tripping. But yeah, they don't look too bad to be Revolution, honestly. They're actually quite pretty. So yeah, and I love the fact that there's this really dark shade in here, so I can really just blow that out, you know, or blow one of these out in my crease, deepen it up, and then, you know, add a shimmer or whatever. So yeah, that's not bad. Just taking a quick look at that. This one, honestly, I really, really wanted to return this. This is from Pixie. It's the Hello Kitty Eye FX. I don't know what made me grab this when I was in the store. I think I just wanted to buy some new makeup or some new eyeshadow, as usual. But this is not something I would typically gravitate towards. And this palette was not cheap. I think this palette was like $20 or $22 or something. I don't remember. But it's cute. You know, it's part of a little Pixie and Hello Kitty collab. And let's see. This is what these shades look like. So, you know, there's some pretty nice, gorgeous, deep shades in here. Not really sure on the quality. I don't think I've ever tried Pixie eyeshadow, and just from these swatches, I am not impressed. I am not impressed. But anyway, you know, a lot of eyeshadows are not meant to be super aggressive. You know, some of them are just meant to be, you know, pretty shimmers that you put on your eyes and go on about your day, you know. But me being an indie girly, I mean, they're not bad. They're not bad at all, really. But me being an indie brand lover, you know, I'd be looking for that wham, bam, pow, okay? So, but honestly, I'm actually a little impressed. I'm not as disappointed as I thought I was going to be. So, I feel like I could do something with that, for sure. Okay, next for drugstore, I got this Black Radiance Brilliant Effects Eyeshadow Palette in Midnight Magic. And I grabbed this because I really wanted to just try out a Black Radiance palette. I don't think I've ever tried Black Radiance eyeshadow. I've tried a lot of their other beauty products, but as far as eyeshadow goes, never tried it. And when I saw the colors in this, When I saw the colors in this palette, I was like, okay, you know, nice and deep and rich. So let's go ahead and check it out. What I want to do is, let me swatch some of these mattes because I am curious about the mattes in here. And I'm not even sure because of how they... Ooh, that's dark. I'm not even sure because of how... Yeah, they look decently pigmented, actually. I'm not even sure, just looking at this palette, like which, oh, that's pretty. A lot of people don't like the glittery sequins type mats, but I do. I actually love to see that. The glitter in the mat. Oh, okay. I am impressed. This burgundy one here. It's nicely pigmented. This one is gorgeous. This shade here and that black. This is the black with the sequins in it, so you can still see that glitter. But yeah, I was really curious as far as the mattes with this palette, and just looking at that, I'm actually quite impressed. Actually quite impressed. Okay, so it looks like this one and these two are shimmers, and that's the thing that just lets me know. No, that one don't look like a shimmer. I don't know what that is. This one's a shimmer. This gold right here, that's a shimmer. And, okay, so that orange is a shimmer. Ooh, very, very lackluster. Not impressed at all. So, the mattes, it looks like, yeah, these shimmers, not impressed at all. But it looks like the mattes are going to be... Ooh! Okay, so I have to work with that one a little differently, that yellow. But yeah, these shimmers, yeah, no, uh-uh. Not impressed at all with the shimmers. The mattes, yeah, very nice, but the shimmers not so much. So I would say if you like the shades of the mattes in here, which these two bottom rows and this one here, I think are all mattes, but the shimmers, which are the golds, no, not impressed at all. So yeah. Okay, and I think these are the last two drugstore palettes I have, I think. Unless we consider Morphe drugstore now. I don't know. Since they're at Ulta, I'm not sure. But this palette, every time I saw somebody with this palette, this NYX Ultimate Vintage Jean Baby palette, I was like, I want that. It's so cute. I love the color story. And I was just like... And so I went on a mission to find it, and I did. Actually, I think I found these on Amazon. So I went ahead, that instant gratification, next day thing. Went on Amazon, ordered these. I don't remember how much they were. Maybe like 14, 15 bucks. You know, NYX is a little bit pricier as far as drugstore goes, but their quality is usually a bit better. But I just thought it was so cute. I like the little impressions of the pockets for the blue jean and the color story. I just thought it was cute. You have your neutrals up top, your blues on the bottom, and the shimmers look pretty nice. And then I also grabbed this one because this one caught my eye as well. I only wanted the vintage jean baby, but when I saw this one on there, this caught my eye as well. Gorgeous neutrals, that beautiful pop of green, pop of red. I was just like, you know, it's cute, I want it. So I picked up these two, but I actually got these off of Amazon next day, honey. Okay, so before I jump into all of these indie palettes, because that's pretty much what I have left is indie palettes, but I do have a couple of palettes that I purchased from Ulta that I really wanted. And then I have some fragrance as well. I think I'll do the fragrance last. But from Ulta, I bought two Morphe palettes. This one is the Meredith Duxbury, and I really like the packaging on here. It has like those wet droplets. Really, really cute. And this is what it looks like. So it's kind of like a face and eye palette. And what drew me to this was the fact that it wasn't just the regular boring neutral shades. I saw, you know, the really pretty pop of pink here, which can be used on the eyes as well as a blush. I saw these gorgeous highlighter shades here. Of course, this caught my eye because it was unique. I like the beautiful swirling in the pan. The fact that there's a black in here really excites me because, you know, I can deepen anything up with that eye looks, use it as an eyeliner. And then the neutral shades are even really pretty to me. I feel like they have a little bit more warmth and depth than some other palettes that would only have so few shades. A lot of times they put so many light shades in there that I really can't do nothing with. But this I can definitely do something with and create a beautiful eye look, as well as use it on my cheeks for highlighter and for blush. So I grabbed that. Also, from Morphe, Laura, I know it was the commercial, okay? I know it was that little Instagram ad that I saw for this Nude Ambition, okay? The packaging got me, just the lighting, the swoop-de-doop that they was doing on there, it got me, because, child. But how they showed this palette, definitely not anything I needed. But this is actually really nice for travel. It's not super huge, it's not tiny, but it's not super duper huge, and it has a nice range. If you just wear neutral shades, beautiful warm tones and things like that, but you also like to just smoke it out when you go out, like at night or on a date, or if you're traveling and maybe, you know, for daytime you want to keep it simple, but at night you just want to go in and smoke it out a little bit, this is perfect for that. And I love the fact that they have the middle row of shimmers, and they look like really, really pretty shimmers. Okay, so yeah, I actually like Morphe's formula. It's one of those for me where if I want to do a nice basic look and I kind of want to have the option to build it up or keep it nice and soft, I can do that. I really like buildable shadows. Like the eye look I have on today, if you're curious, this eye look, which is pretty aggressive, but I love me a halo eye, child. Halo eye, if I could do those all the time, I would. This is my Amy Loves and Adept collab palette, and this is what I used for this eye look today. I just did a halo eye and put one of the gorgeous shimmers in the center, okay. A cool tone dream. This palette is gorgeous. I love it. I love the cool tone blue. It was just so easy to do this eye look. I used this in my crease. That's what I put down first. I deepened the outer and inner corners with this. And then I used this duochrome. This duochrome or multi-chrome shade in the center. And it's just, child, I love it, love it, love it, love it. But this is the palette that I have on my eyes today. And these mattes from Adept are buildable. They have a beautiful amount of pigment. They're not dull or weak by any means, but some seriously pigmented eyeshadows, you go in and it's just like, oh my gosh, okay, that was too much, you know, just from one tap. But with these, they're nicely buildable and easy to blend. I love it, love it, love it. I love Adept shadows, and that is what I have on my eyes today, if you are curious. It's the Amy Loves palette. And then I got this Tarte palette. I got this. Did I get this from Ulta or Sephora? I might have got this from Sephora, now that I think about it. I ordered it on one of their same day deliveries because I saw I saw somebody with this. This is the Tarte Lit Reflections palette. I guess it's their 25-year anniversary palette. 25 years of female-founded, cruelty-free formulas infused with good-for-you ingredients and kindness. But I love shiny packaging. Okay, it has that mirrored packaging, so I don't want to blind you, but it's gorgeous, and it has like these fireworks on here. Really pretty. But let me show you what this palette looks like. It's gorgeous. There's a mirror in here, as you can see. You can see all my stuff all on my desk. But there's a gorgeous mirror, and it says Tarte Lit on the mirror, as you can see there. But this palette, oh, it was so pretty to me. When I tell you, I have no shame in buying makeup or palettes for the beauty of it, none, because I'm a collector, so none. So whether or not I use this palette, I'm not sure, because it does have some really gorgeous imprints in there. But it's definitely a palette that I would use, having the black in there, having those gorgeous warm tones in there, the beautiful shimmers. It's definitely a palette that I would use. But do I want to mess up the imprints? Haven't decided yet. But yeah, it is beautiful. Just looking at it now, it's gorgeous. So yeah, I saw someone with it. I didn't even know that it existed. But honey, when I saw it, I immediately was like, I want it. I want it in my collection. Even if it's one of the items that I just put in my new vanity, you know, so you can see it through the glass. Honey, it's beautiful, okay? So I got that. Okay, so I think now we can kind of move into some indie brands before I go into the fragrance I bought. I only bought one multi-pack of fragrance and then one other like body spray or whatever. So yeah, let's just go through some of these indie brands. So this is from Clarity Cosmetics. This is a palette that I guess was just like a surprise drop from them because I hadn't seen anything on it. It's the Stained Glass from Clarity Cosmetics. Packaging is gorgeous. It does have an outer carton. The carton has the ingredients and information on it. The palette does not. So if you want this information, you got to keep the carton. But it's just so pretty. Look at that. So pretty. And when I saw the color story, I was like, yeah, no, I'm getting it. I couldn't even front like I wasn't. I was like, yeah, we getting that. It's gorgeous. And it's like, I know, oh, all that feels so beautiful. It's like, I know that I love Clarity's shimmers. I love their mattes. Okay, these are the shimmers. These be the shimmers, okay. So let me just pretty my little old wrinkled hands. So yeah, gorgeous, really, really gorgeous. This one here, this first one, I don't think I got that one good enough because it kind of skipped on my hand, but oh yeah, that is really pretty, really pretty. I like them because they're different. You know, it's not like the typical shimmers that you would expect to see like in a green palette. So let me swatch these mattes right quick. Yep. Mm-hmm. Ooh. Okay, and then, oh, Lord have mercy. This green shimmer down here. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Oh my goodness, child. Sitting here with my little, oh, that's pretty. My little dehydrated fingers. I really need to drink some more water. But that's those three. So, so pretty. Oh my gosh. Yeah. That's gorgeous. Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. Nicely pigmented and beautiful. I would do an eye look with these four right here. Those four shadows. And pop that one maybe in my inner corner just to give a little, you know, a little bit of depth or whatever. But, oh. Ooh, child. So, that's the Stained Glass palette from Clarity. If you like that color story, which I do, I love it. I can see those shadows on my eyes already. Okay, next I have this palette from Unearthly. I ordered a few palettes from Unearthly, actually. Let me do all four of these at the same time. So this one is the Lore palette. So that's what that one looks like. And these palettes aren't new. I guess they've been out for a while, but I hadn't been purchasing, you know, palettes from Unearthly. So when I took a look at these, I was like, oh, those are pretty, really, really pretty color stories. I don't really want to swatch these. I want to keep them kind of pristine because I'm not sure what type of content I want to create with these, but I just felt like this color story and these shimmers, gorgeous. Okay, this next one is the Sorceress Smoke. I've seen a lot of people that really, really love this palette. I love the color story, of course. It's a beautiful, earthy color story, kind of green leaning, but still a little bit warm. No, it's cool, actually. Still a bit cool neutral. And just looking at the combination of shimmers and mattes, I know this will create a really pretty kind of cool tone, you know, earthy green eye look, but not like super duper green. I don't feel like it would come out super duper green, but I feel like it's just kind of unique. When I think about green palettes that I really love, I think about like Melt Cosmetics or Clarity, you know, palettes that really drive a green punch. But that one, I feel like it's a little bit unique in my collection. This is the Dreamer palette. I fell in love with the packaging on this. I don't know why. I thought she was just really cool. And then the color story. Okay, of course. Beautiful pinky purple color story. Ugh. And I saw, who was it? Betty Bean. I think I saw Betty Jean do a gorgeous eye look with this. I was watching one of her videos and she said that she had used this for her eye look. I think she was ranking her unearthly palettes. And I was like, Lord have mercy, I need that palette. That eye look was so pretty. So she got me to grab that one. And then this Devour palette. Very interesting cover art. But this one is a little bit more aggressive on the green side. It has some burgundies, you know, some really pretty shimmers, and then that bright pop of green right there, which would really look gorgeous in the inner corner of a green eye look. So yeah, just really, really gorgeous. And there's a few videos of, you know, indie brand lovers that are testing these palettes, swatching them and everything. So if you really want to see swatches of those palettes in particular, you could definitely find them online. Okay, so this palette I got from Fantasy Cosmetica. I do have a couple more palettes that are on the way from Fantasy Cosmetica, which haven't reached me yet. This is the Fighter palette. This is the first one that I grabbed because I was really interested in this color story. Like I said, I'm just cool tone to the bone right now. And this color story, very unique to me. Gorgeous. I felt like these shimmers were quite unique. And I really just wanted to have this in my collection. It doesn't go with the mattes. It doesn't go as deep as I might would like matte-wise, but that's okay. That's okay because, you know, I don't always want a super deep dark eye look. So I don't always have to have a super deep dark matte. Oh, look at those shimmers. Child, what? I don't always have to have a super deep dark matte to play with. And if I decide I do, I have 5 million palettes to pull one from. So yeah, those shimmers, so pretty. Right up my alley right now. I'm loving those colors. Even with this, I feel like this is a matte shade that actually would look darker on my eye than I might think that it would looking at it in the pan. So this matte, this in the inner corner with any of these gorgeous shimmers, beautiful eye look. So I did, I think because I have the fan blowing on me, it's kind of messing with my nose and my sinuses, but y'all, it's too hot out here in Vegas for me to be sitting here melting. It is way too hot, honey. I have got to have a fan blowing on me or y'all would literally see my makeup melting off my face because it would be too hot. But yeah, I actually have two more palettes. I'll actually tell you guys what other two palettes I'm waiting on, just in case you're curious. So I'm waiting on the Bard palette. So this is what the Bard palette looks like. And then I'm also waiting on the Warlock palette. So these are the other two color stories that I was interested in on the Fantasy Cosmetica website, and those are the other two palettes that I've ordered that I'm waiting on. So, and then some other palettes that I'm waiting on just while I'm looking at my phone is this Foursome. This is the Element palette bundle from Lethal Cosmetics. I guess I did, it was, you know, pre-order status or whatever, coming back into stock. So still waiting on those. And then I also ordered this Midnight Serenade palette, which I thought was really, really gorgeous. So I'm waiting for that to come in the same order. So those are the items that I haven't received yet that I was hoping would come in time for this haul, but did not. Okay, so next, Adept came out with another gorgeous palette. Look at the packaging. What? Adept is, I feel like they're like at the top of their game and the top of the game when it comes to packaging and shimmers, okay? Now this palette, honestly, I'm like, am I gonna use this? Am I gonna use this? Am I going to touch these gorgeous shadows? These two here, when I looked at them, I was like, wait a minute, did I get two of the same shadow? But then when I looked at them closely and I looked at, you know, the pics from the website and stuff, I was like, no, they're different. They're different. But yeah, this is one of those palettes where I'm like, oh, am I going to use that? Or is this just going to be part of my collection? Because she is a beauty. Oh, she's gorgeous. The matte shades, that purple, that pink. Even this here, this beautiful, like, light peachy corally shade. And, you know, you can see these shimmers, honey. Just, whoo, amazing. If I can find a nice swatch picture from someone, I'll go ahead and insert it here so you can see what the shadows look like swatched. But this, what is it? The Legend of Ardra? The Legend of Ardra. You can see there, Legend of Ardra. And look at, just look at the detailing on this package. Ciao. Gorgeous. So y'all might never see that palette again unless it's in a palette collection video, honey, because I don't think I'm going to use that. It's beautiful. Y'all might think I'm crazy, like, who buys palettes not to use them? Me. I do. I have plenty of palettes that I can use, okay? And here's one of them. This one is the Beauty Bay Botanical Palette. I did use this. I actually did a video on this if you want to check it out. It was just so gorgeous. I was like, you know what? Let me go ahead and do a video on this. And this is what she looks like. Lots of beautiful shimmers in there, as you can see. Lots of gorgeous shimmers. And it's like this lighting is not even doing these shimmers justice. But I just love the whole color story of this palette. It's beautiful. Like I said, if you want to see a more in-depth, you know, video on this palette, I did do one, so you can look that up. Ooh, child, easy now. Easy. I picked this up, the Ace Beauté Palette-opoly. Is that what it is? Palette-opoly? It was on sale, and I've always loved the colors of this palette. I don't care about the game or anything like that. I don't even know if I kept the box with the game and stuff, but I just wanted the palette. This is, yeah, Ace Beauté. The color story, gorgeous. I love everything about this color story. It's beautiful. I love the grunginess here in the center. I love the beautiful bright pinks. These greens, just, you know, nice light blues over here. It's beautiful. I do. I love this color story. As you can see, the shimmers are gorgeous as well. It's not like overly shimmer heavy or overly matte heavy. I think it's a really nice balance in here, even though it looks like there's more mattes. But I feel like it's a really nice balance of shades in here. So that's why I grabbed it, honey. I've always wanted it. I was like, I don't need a game for my eyeshadow. But when it went on sale, I was like, I'm gonna grab that one because it's pretty. This one here, I was like, I'm not buying that. The Cosmic Dreamer from Inslee Rain. I was like, I'm not buying this because I bought the first one. Didn't like it. The first version of this that they came out with, I don't know, I guess it was last year or something. I did not like it. I was not pleased at all. But after trying their newer palettes, you know, the ones that I fell in love with, the Flower Moon and anyway, y'all know what I'm talking about. Those palettes, gorgeous. Shimmers, gorgeous. Mattes, gorgeous. And when I saw the, you know, new, because this is basically a totally different palette. This is not the same as the original one at all, in my opinion. The colors are better in here. The layout is better. The shimmers, I could just look at them and see they're better. And it's just like they really did a nice upgrade with this palette. And I fought it for a long time because I was like, you know, these indie brands and their pricing, it's just, it's really getting out of hand. But I just, after I hemmed and hawed over it for months, literally months, of do you want that in your collection? Because that's really how I think of things now and see things now. I don't buy makeup for my channel. I don't, because I really don't review. I don't do a lot of review videos, and I don't do a lot of, tutorials and stuff anymore, because people don't really watch them. But when I decide whether or not I want to buy makeup now, it's do I want it? Do I want it in my collection, in my room, with my palettes for me to use or to just have? And I wanted it. I said, you know what? It's beautiful. I want it. The other one, I can declutter or give it away. You know, I love when brands go in and redo their formulas, make them better, increase their quality and things like that for the consumer. And so I appreciated that. And even though I feel like this palette was quite pricey, how many shades are there in here? 25? I think this palette might be like $72 or something like that. $75. I don't know. But it's pretty pricey for an eyeshadow palette. But I wanted it, so I bought it. It's gorgeous. I got it. Now, this one here, this is from Glam Light. And listen, the theming of this palette, I've never been into Kiss. I remember them being really big when I was like in elementary school. I think it was like the 80s or something when they were really, really big, if I'm not mistaken. Late 80s. Yeah, it had to be in the 80s. It wasn't in the 90s. Anyway, when I was in elementary school, I remember them being really big. Don't care about that at all. Never listened to Kiss. Wasn't into it. You know, it probably felt like, thought it was devil worship at the time. But, you know, it's just like, whatever. Now, you know, I see they're just, you know, they're just a rock band or whatever. But the coloring, this is the box, the packaging. Really cute. You know, Glam Light goes above and beyond with their packaging and stuff. But so it comes in this box here, but this is the actual palette, and it has that packaging where it flips and it changes, you know, when you do like that. So that's pretty cool. Like I said, even though I don't care about Kiss as a band, the color story, and this is what the mirror looks like. It has them, you know, there on the mirror. If you can see that, you can see my little cup. Okay, I got my juice here that is keeping me hydrated. The cup says Florida because I went to visit one of my friends in Florida. And child, honey, I'm not leaving the airport without something. Okay, when I go to the airport, wherever I go, I have sweatshirts from everywhere, you know, that I've been. I have cups from different states. It's like, honey, when I'm in the airport, I'm leaving with something, okay? So anyway, I thought this cup was really cute. It's really pretty. Kind of matches me today. But anyways, got my little juice. But this is the palette, okay? Gorgeous jewel tones, blues, purples, pinky reds, greens. You know, there's a black, which I love. Always love a black and a white in a palette. It just kind of helps you to kind of lighten things, deepen things, however you want to. But this color story, chef's kiss. I don't know if it really says kiss to me, because I would think for Kiss it would just kind of be red, white, and black, just from what I remember as a kid, you know, thinking about them just like red, white, and black. But I guess if you want to make a jewel tone, I'll take it, honey. Okay, this palette, I'll get to these three last. But this palette is the Rick and Morty 30 shade palette. I don't know if you guys are familiar with the Rick and Morty cartoon. My husband loves to watch this cartoon. I just be like, this is ridiculous, okay? The adult cartoons just be out of hand, way out of hand, out of control, okay? But yeah, I don't know. For some reason,
men really like to watch them adult cartoons. And when I watch them, you know, I get a little chuckle every now and then. But the Rick and Morty cartoon, and this one is from Glamlight as well, of course, but really, really cute packaging. Really, really cute. And the color story was gorgeous to me. Just beautiful. Once again, jewel tones. But I really, really like, and as you can see, Rick and Morty is right here looking stupid, but that's what they're doing. But I really like this first row. I'm intrigued by this first row here with these beautiful, like, light peachy orange tangerine shades that will go beautifully with the greens in here. Blues, beautiful, some gorgeous purples. These purples, oh, so, so pretty. So this palette has a really nice range. You know, I can create several different looks from this palette. It's beautiful. I fell in love with the color story, so got that. So lastly, these three palettes, I probably like, no, I won't say probably, I think most likely are the most expensive set of palettes that I bought. And these are from Cleona. These are their latest palettes. The Archeo, Paleo, and Oceana. Okay? So, these three palettes I got from Cleona. Wasn't sure if I was going to go ahead and grab them, but I did. So, this one is the Archeo palette. Gorgeous, gorgeous. I think, as far as color stories go, this one might be my favorite. So this is what this palette looks like. Beautiful, beautiful mattes, gorgeous shimmers. And so that's what that one looks like. This one is the Paleo. I love the packaging on this. Really, really pretty. And yeah, this color story is gorgeous as well, but it is just your typical blues and neutrals in here. Really, really pretty. And then this is the Oceano. That packaging is pretty as well. And it really gives you an idea that, you know, there's blues and greens. There's this gorgeous pop of purple, which is probably like a multi-chrome, duochrome. There are videos out on these palettes of people using them, swatching them, going in depth with the shimmers and the mattes and just kind of showing you. I'm pretty sure Millie did videos on these, if I'm not mistaken. And if she did, I'm sure she did comparisons and things. But yeah, these palettes are really, really pretty, really gorgeous. And, you know, if you are curious about more information on these palettes, there are a few creators, I believe, that have done in-depth videos on these palettes. I wanted these palettes because I love the fact that they are magnetic, so I can take the shadows out, move them around, you know, create my own palettes with them and just kind of have some fun that way. Because I won't say that the color stories were my absolute favorites, but as I looked at the different shadows individually, I was like, oh, you know, this will look pretty with that. This will look pretty with that. I can, you know, kind of play around with this and that. So I do love the fact that their shadows are magnetic so that I can do that. Okay, so enough of all that. Lastly, I did pick up this Kaoli. What is it? The Vacay in a Bottle miniature set. So these are their new, you know, vacay scents or vacation scents, if you will. In this cute little traveler's pack, which I really like. So they have Marrakesh in a bottle, Capri in a bottle, Maui in a bottle, and Maldives in a bottle. And I did already smell these. And I believe that Maldives was my favorite one. So let's just go ahead and take a quick look. This is so pretty. It really is. It's so, so pretty. Look at this. This is gorgeous. It's really, really pretty. And so these I will definitely be going like in my travel bag whenever I go on cruises or vacations or trips and stuff. I love this size of perfume to travel with. And with them being travel scents, It's perfect for that. Okay, so this one is the Marrakesh in a bottle. Is that the one that I said I really like? Let me look at the back here. So Marrakesh in a bottle. Hold on now. I don't know who I thought I was. Is the bergamot, orange blossom, pink pepper, Turkish rose, neroli, and cedarwood. Okay. All right, Marrakesh. So, Marrakesh. So this one I'm going to spray. I'm going to spray this one right here on this wrist. I'm going to be smelling so vacation-y tropical with all of these scents on me. But they all smell really good. Oh, that smells good. It's so funny because it smells like Marrakesh. Whatever you picture Marrakesh smelling like, you know, seeing the buildings or whatever with the, you know, the triangle top buildings, the just, yeah. It just makes me think of a marketplace. It has lots of different scents, lots of different, like, what are they called? Diffusers or the, dang, what are those things called that you light, you know, and they smoke and smell up the room and stuff. It's not super strong or anything, but it's something in there that it definitely makes me think of Marrakesh. I don't know if it's the pink pepper or the Turkish rose, the neroli. I don't know, honey, but yeah, I feel like, yeah. It definitely makes me think of Marrakesh, even though I've never been there. That's what it smells like. That's what I would assume it smells like, okay? Okay, next. This one is Capri in a bottle. So this is the yellow one. Lemon, sugar, freesia, raspberry, vanilla, and musk, okay? So lemon sugar is like the description for this one. So I'm gonna spray this one up a little higher. Ooh, it smells just like lemon sugar, honey. That smells like a delicious, like sparkling glass of delicious lemonade. Ooh, I like that. I don't know. Ooh, dang. That's tough. Those two are tough. I like both of them. I'm not sure. I don't know. I thought for sure it was the Marrakesh and now the Capri. But if I remember correctly, those two were the top two for me. So it's kind of close. They smell very different. The lemon sugar, the Capri is very sweet. So if you don't like sweet perfumes, you probably won't like it. And typically I don't, but I think that lemon in there is just really kind of setting it off. I love both of those. Very different scents and they both smell amazing. Okay, so this is Maui. Maui in a bottle. Sweet banana, pear, coconut cream, jasmine, sandalwood, and vanilla. Okay, so this one I'm gonna spray on this side. It definitely smells like Maui. I've been to Hawaii a few times now. Three times. Oh, this smells beautiful. Oh, it smells beautiful. Now, this smells like vacation. Definitely smells like Hawaii. Reminds me of Hawaii, the ocean breeze, the beautiful sands, just the it's making me think of the Hawaiian dresses everywhere, luau. Yeah, whatever that smells like, this is what that smells like. It smells amazing. Okay, so this one here is Maldives in a bottle. Rosemary, wild lemon, star fruit, banana blossom, yang yang, and coconut milk. Okay, so this is the blue one, which is the Maldives. Okay, so let me spray this one here. It smells nice. Yeah, it's not my favorite. It's not. This will probably be my last choice, honestly. The Maldives, it doesn't stink. It smells really good. Actually, it smells beautiful. But for me personally, it would not be my first choice. So yeah, really, really nice scent. I would say for me, my favorite is going to be the lemon sugar, the Capri. I would think is my favorite, which is surprising to me because it's very sweet. And I don't typically like super sweet scents. And then after that, I would say the Maldives. Yeah, after that, I would say the Maldives, which is the blue one. So the yellow and the blue are my favorite. Then I would say it's Maui. And then lastly, I would say it's Marrakesh, even just because it's a little aggressive for me. Okay, so yeah, so that is this scent, my thoughts on that. And then lastly, I got this Moroccan oil. This is actually, what does it say, Brumes de Maroc. It's a fragrance mist for the body and the hair. And I got it, as you can see, I've been using this like crazy already. But I got a sample of this with one of my Sephora orders. And I knew immediately when I sprayed it and put it on myself that I wanted it. I love this stuff. It smells so good. I don't know what the notes are. I'll put it here if, you know, I can find it. But it smells so good. And the only thing I don't like about it is it doesn't last a long time. After I spray it, it seems like it dissipates rather quickly. So I don't know if they actually make a fragrance or oil or something that I can combine with this or layer with this that would prolong the scent. If so, oh my gosh, I'll wear this every day. It smells so freaking good. So yeah, this is what it is if you're curious. And I'm definitely loving this ever since I purchased it. So, but that's it, you guys. That's my whole beauty haul for now. Everything that I have purchased and the items that I'm still waiting on. Just wanted to kind of share and explore them with you and let you know what's new to me in my collection. And now I can go ahead and just start putting these things away, using them, having fun with them, creating content with them. And that'll do it. So I hope you guys have an amazing rest of the week, morning, afternoon, night, whenever you're watching this. If you enjoyed this content, don't forget to hit like and subscribe. And I will see you on the next one. Toodles!